Hello everybody and welcome to another video. In this video it's going to be my Air Tycoon 4 series. Now last time we were setting up a bunch of routes with the 737 200. I remember we got the 100 and yeah, there's really no point in that, and I need to turn it down yet again because I always keep on forgetting to do that. There we go. Doesn't need to be too loud, just get that on the frame like that. There we go. So yeah, actually just make it so I can actually tap on it without it falling over, because I did that before and yeah, screwed up the recording. So yeah, where do we get these 727s from? I don't know, my stomach rumbled. Oh, I have no idea. So yeah, I can't remember if I said, because I recorded it a while ago. Yeah, last episode, yeah, I said, it's in the way. Last episode, I said about, yeah, I was probably going to set up all these 77 routes out of episode, but I, yeah, I only did a few. Oh, I'm thinking about doing them in episode. I really like the idea of time-lapse, so I don't really want to do them outside of episode. I think a good time-lapse while I do it, because, yeah, it's, you can see it if you want to see it, then you can, it's good for everybody, because if you want to see it, you can, and, yeah. And if you don't, then you can sort of, yeah, it'll be over pretty quickly. So, yeah, it's not like, yeah, I'm going to be doing it the whole episode. Yeah. After this, I should think, yeah. Now, where did these seven, let me just have a look. I just want to find out where these, where those 727s come from, because, yeah, I haven't recorded this for quite a while, and, yeah, I am, losing track a bit, so, yeah. I should have a look at our routes. Ooh, they're not exactly 100% occupancy, but whatever. If I see, any sort of, yeah, like GCA 11 routes with the 727, I guess maybe, I don't know. Well, in fact, I wouldn't be able to see, would I? I don't know. Los Angeles, Las Vegas, that could have been 77 before. Yeah, and New York to Toronto, yeah, they were. New York to Toronto and Los Angeles, Las Vegas, I think there were 77 routes. I can't remember. Don't know. It would, seem plausible anyway, so yeah. Now, I'll put up these 737 routes, if you, yeah. And we didn't see last episode, the places I'm sort of going to are places with 100 business and tour, so like, I'll be going to, Chihuahua, like Chihuahua, basically. There's a place, there's a dog in Mexico, San Antonio maybe, Harlingen maybe, Monterrey, yeah, Tampico, yeah. Guadalajara, all sort of like 77 places. Yeah, places like that. I'll be going to like that, and also over the over the US. I'll be going to places like that, and yeah, that will do that pretty good. So like with Quebec, I think, yeah, and Ottawa, yeah, just all those places. I'll probably be going from LA because yeah, I have. If you have actually have a look. If I just, yeah, do that. It looks like, it definitely, I don't know about you, but it looks like there's a lot more routes from New York than there is, Los Angeles. So, yeah, we'll be going from Los Angeles. And Los Angeles is meant to be my hub. And, yeah, I think what it is just because, yeah, I've got so many routes going into Europe now. And, yeah, I can't actually set up routes going, to anywhere, further than, the Hawaiian Islands. Yeah, like, into Asia and that, because, yeah. I mean, the DC-8s have enough range, but, yeah, I think it's, the high capacity ones, yeah, the DC-8-61 that has high capacity, but yeah, it doesn't go. It barely goes anywhere, so yeah. And it barely has, has about, I can't, how much range does it have? Let's have a little investigation, not DC-8-11. Yeah, I can't remember how much range it has, it's 3,000 miles and something, yeah, 3,749 miles, that one down there, that's one I, upgraded. And yeah, so I could actually get the range, because I didn't anticipate how short of a range it had, so yeah. I'm not using the DC-862 because it has barely any range. It has the same capacity as the 77-200. So yeah, and I'll not be doing that. Yeah, until the DC-8 and the 747 come out. Since the 727 then. Yeah, when the 747 and DC-8 come out, DC-10 come out. Sorry. Yeah, I'll do that. And yeah, they'll be coming out in about a year's time. So after I put these, I won't buy any planes. As you can see, I've got about 259 million in the bank. So yeah. Yeah, I won't be buying anything else after I set up these routes, so yeah, I'll stop blabbering on, as I usually do in these videos, and yeah. Now I'll have to get onto the time-lapse, and yeah, I'll just set up a bunch more routes. I'm not going to be in a while, yet again, here a while. I can't speak. Just shut up and do it. after over half an hour of doing that, I have finally put in all of the routes with the 737. So, yeah, those are two sevens. I also sort of put them on routes which I thought were viable, which were going to... Where were they going to? I can't remember where. It was, Louisville, I do believe. Oh, no, I didn't mean to go on there. No! Which come off of there. It was definitely Louisville. And where else was it? Was it Minneapolis? No, it wasn't. I can't remember. It was Montreal, I think. Yes, it was Montreal. So, that was originally going to be a 737 route, and I put all the slots in and everything. And then, I couldn't be really bothered to, upgrade and everything. So I thought, I'll just put 727 in. That's probably never going to be that profitable, but whatever. I think, as it expands, and it'll be, As popularity arises, then it should be okay. It's just as we go through time. So I ended up putting in were. I was going to just see if I can remember them, but it's better to go on here. Blimmin' heck, we have got a lot of routes. So which ones have we put in? I've just realised that's 129. A bunch of them are 129, and that's sort of annoying. The occupancy, I mean, it doesn't have to be exactly at, 100%. I want to try and get it above, 90% if I can. The game says above 70, but I think that's way too low. I think about 90, if it's 90 or above, then it should be okay. The route to Montreal, from New York, that's making, in fact, if the 737's only doing that, then the 727's not going to be very good, is it? Well done me, that's making 2 million, that's not very, only got 90%, only, it's got, 90% in, occupancy, and, see, this is what I hate about the game sometimes, I got 90% occupancy, and it's making that, it doesn't actually matter too much, there's another route going to Monterrey. Both of them are like that, I'll just, Oh, really? And of course you blimmit. That's the sort of thing that makes you get... Sort of thing that gets on your nerves sometimes. That one's doing it as well. Why does it do that? Why do you go down to 129? Why? And now you're blimmin' doing that again. Stop! What have I ever done to Air Tycoon 4? Good grief. I'll go to Salt Lake City as well. What is it? Jeez. Sometimes I wonder, right? Now let's actually get onto the routes we actually did put in. Which are okay. Including those other ones. And someone just flushed the toilet, if you wonder what that noise is. You can hear that in the background. Yeah, someone's touched a toilet. That's a pipe that goes right through my cupboard. And that's the link to that. So what did we put in? We put, the 727, we did Los Angeles to Montreal and to Louisville. And I'll probably have to swap out that 727 eventually. But yeah, from Los Angeles with the 727, we went to Chihuahua. Is that Chihuahua or Chichihuahua? I don't know, something like that. I went to Portland, Calgary, Anchorage, Edmonton, Minneapolis, Monterrey, Guadalajara, New Orleans, Tampico, Mazatlan. Almost said Mazatlan then. Indianapolis, Winnipeg, Buffalo, and Salt Lake City. So, there's a bunch more routes onto our network. I'm just going to go and, I'm just going to this turn. This is going to be going to be the second part of the episode, and jeez, 131 million. we're getting very profitable, and the DC-940 is on the market yet again. As I've said before, I am not going to be purchasing the DC-9 in this series. I don't know about the MD-80 series. That's actually got business on it. I think because there's things like the 757, and it's sort of between the in the 1980s, it'll be more between, like, the 737-400 and, sort of like the 757 200, and I just kicked something behind me. Trying to stretch my legs out, but yeah. Hang on. 1969? Oh, it's February. For a second though, I thought it was January that the 747, took its first flight. It was the 9th of February, 1969, so yeah, we should be getting it. Oh, we're going up in profit again. And here we are, we've got 81 routes, here we are, the 747 has, taken its first flight. Apparently the freighter version took its first flight on the exact same day, which it didn't. Nobody really knows when the freighter versions take flight, do they? So I'm having like the 777 and something like that, or the Antonov AN-225. Basically, dedicated, freighter aircraft. Other than that, no. No one ever does. So that is 747, and I made a weird noise in my mouth then. And the F-28's on. Concorde. Yep, that is going to be, I guess, the only sort of unprofitable plane I'm getting. The only reason I'm getting it is simply because it's Concorde. Yeah, I don't know whether I'm going to be doing a few routes of it. I'm only going to be doing, in fact, it is actually quite good, I've just realised, because if you're doing long haul, if you want to do a long haul route with, which hasn't got that much, which is not that popular, so I guess I could go from New York to, where could I go, sort of like a long haul route, New York to the Canary Islands, maybe? What's the Canary Islands like? Yeah, I could go to the Canary Islands, something like that. I'm gonna do that sort of like a holiday destination. Oh, I could go to Barbados like it actually did. Can I go to Barbados? No, it's not open yet. Oh my life, look how small that is! It's got 12 in business and 25 in tour. Yeah, that will change, I should think, a bunch of these places, but yeah. I won't be going to any of them quite yet, but yeah, they are definitely on the list of things that I will be going to eventually, so yeah. Like Jamaica and Cuba and, like Haiti and that, so yeah. And so with Concorde, then I guess we'll be doing that, so yeah. I mean, Concorde, I don't have to worry about Concorde because it doesn't come out until 1976, if you didn't know, it ended service in January 1976. So yeah, it did 7 years of test flying, which is, pretty big. But considering it's the world's first, I was going to say the world's first operational was supersonic airline, it's not actually, that was the TU-144. Considering it was a very, very sophisticated airliner, and a lot was expected of it, that's pretty understandable. A lot of it was actually to do with, like, route proving and stuff, especially in, like, from about 1974 onwards. A little bit of trivia about Concorde there, And like I said, the rest of this episode is basically going to be sort of watching our money roll in. I guess after this term we can take a look at how my routes are doing. We're about hovering about 132 million, which is a definite increase on what we had before. We were hovering about 100 million that time. The 727-200F is coming out. Which again, I'm not going to be using. I'll just have to get some more fuel. It's actually going down in price. Thank you. Yeah, last episode it was like, I think it was topping out at 87 million, but yeah, look at that, it's gone up, now it's coming back down again. That's pretty good. Hang on, let me get rid of that alarm, because that will annoy me. we have got 743 million. I won't be able to get screaming amounts of the 747. I don't really want screaming amounts of the 747. What the 747 is going to do, the only route across the US is going to be on is from Los Angeles to New York, because that's a very, very busy route between two of our hubs. And then from LA, it'll probably be going to Tokyo and Beijing and that. And from New York, it will we'd be replacing some of the other European routes, like going to London and Frankfurt and Paris. And I think that's about it. The popular places like Rome, definitely. London, definitely. Paris, definitely. Maybe not definitely Paris. I don't know. No, not Frankfurt either. So yeah, probably London and Rome. That's for definite. Hang on, what about Athens? People were celebrating in the comments after the last episode because I put in the route to Athens. because I haven't actually uploaded part 10 at the time of recording. I don't know about going to Athens. Sorry, guys. We won't be going to Athens with the simple zone, I don't think. Yeah, we'll probably be going with the DC-10 zone. Those are the sort of routes I'll be doing, so I can start to extend my routes out into South America, because you might have seen in the time lapse, I know it's probably going pretty fast, because it did last half an hour for me, So yeah, it'll probably be going pretty quickly for you. But I was having a look at Lima, and that's about DC-10 popularity. So yeah, that'll probably be the DC-10. And what about Rio and Sao Paulo? Yes, DC-10, and that's definitely DC-10. Buenos Aires? Yeah, that's DC-10. And Santiago, that could be 747, just about. I don't know. Any routes I'm not sure on, I'll definitely put the DC-10 on, because I know that that's definitely going to do the job. Yeah, I'll just, what I'll do is I'll put the 747s on the routes, as I've said, which are definitely going to be on there, so New York to LA and New York to London. Like, LA to Tokyo and Beijing and that. Yeah, those will definitely be on the network. For a definite 747 routes. But yeah, if there's any that I'm unsure on, I'll just put the DC-10 on. And yeah, as I said, the DC-10 will be on my domestic services, so replacing the DC-11, so yeah, they'll be going in a couple of years' time. So yeah, we have 31 of them. Is that the most we have in our fleet? Yes, it is. We have 27 37-200s. So yeah, that is pretty good. Yeah, and I've realised what's wrong with the 737, because I have actually got a 737 model now, it's of a British Airways 737-200. Yeah, what it is the engines, there's actually a little bumpy bit, which they've tried to do here. Trade Game Lab, we're trying to edit in. There's a little bit more of a bump there. It doesn't protrude out as far. Fuselage there. Yeah, it's a little bit further. I don't know whether the fuselage is wider, or the engines are slightly too close in, so yeah. I was definitely right about the engines being a bit too close in. I think so, yeah. Engines a bit too close in and everything. But this game isn't really on the looks of the aircraft. They do a good job anyway, but yeah. And this game is more on, the gameplay of it. And not exactly what it looks like, but yeah, it is, it's not always the best, yeah. There's some things with graphics just like them. But yeah, you look past all that and, yeah, look at the good stuff. I'm just actually thinking, New York to Chicago, that could be beefed up to a 747, as well as LA to Chicago. I know it may seem stupid, but when I actually have, I said it before, in part 9, I think. I have in Norwich Airways, which is one of the airlines that this is based off of. That's on my channel somewhere. I was going to say I'll leave a link in the description, but I'll probably forget, so... Just search on my channel, it was uploaded probably about a month ago now. I actually have, on that route, I've done it after I recorded that video, but yeah, I have from New York to LA, a 777-300 on that route, and just before, until the A380 comes out, I'm going to put an A380 on that route. That's how popular that route can be, so yeah. When you can... don't stick to like a 737-200 going to Chicago from LA, because look how much money you can make from that. They're really popular places. So yeah, I'll be definitely putting 747s on them. And the 747s on the routes, which I also said. That'll be, how many 747s will that be? So from LA and New York, so that's two at least. Between them, that's three. LA to New York, four. And New York to London, five. So there's going to be at least five. That we're going to be having to get, and they're about 300 million each, I do believe. I can't exactly remember. I don't exactly remember how much the 100 is. Because I usually get that, and then just, So I say I usually jump to the 200. I did it on in Norwich Airways. I skipped out the 100, I started putting in DC-10s instead. And then, when the 200 came out, I started putting that in. But I will be using the 100 on this. And yeah, it is actually about a year until the 200 comes out. It's not like the 737. Yeah, 100 that comes out, yeah, 2 months before the 200, so there's really no point in buying the 100 at all. Unless you want really low capacity routes, which, you don't usually get in, Tycoon 4, so I do not really use the 100. In fact, I think that's the only time I've ever bought the 100. I might have bought it before, actually. I can't remember. I really can't remember, so Anyway, let's stop blabbering on, and let's just fast-forward the turns. Yeah, I'll be fast-forwarding it until, and we get into, into a 1970, and I'll get to where the 747 is coming out, and the R-62M is coming out. I'm getting a Russian aircraft, I won't be getting it, and, 135 million. Yeah, I will be getting the 747. I'll be getting that next episode. And yeah, I'll just fast forward the turns up until 1970. I was gonna say 1969 then. We already are in 1969. The World Exhibition will be held in Japan in March. So, yeah. If we can get a DC-10 route going through there, then that'll be pretty good. I guess, and it's also a popular place anyway. So, how far is that from LA? That is... Oh, my God. Again, that's another thing that you get annoyed about in Air Tycoon 4, but it's your own fault. It is your own fault half the time. Oh, sucker. 5,716 miles. I think the DC-1030 might have enough range for that. Yeah, it's a DC-1030 route. And yeah, again, don't use the 747s, even though... I mean, I was basing it on what real airlines would do. This is sort of different. I mean, if you want to have a load of spare seats, if you want to make as much money as possible, yeah. Put the DC-10 on, yeah, you'll make as least losses as possible if you optimise your fleets a little bit more. Instead of just whacking 747s on every single long haul route you have, even if it's going from New York to... Dhaka. Yeah. Even if it's something like that, just, yeah. Don't do that. Optimise your routes a little bit more, so, yeah, let's carry on a fast forwarding the turns. I was going to press the recording button on my camera then, for some reason. Let's go on the next turn! Stop recording. That wouldn't help Ibirdball, would it? So, yeah. We are making 135 million. I think that's our top profit for this airline, which is pretty good. And new airports open in South Korea, and there's also typhoons in Taipei and that. I'm currently in August 1969, I'll just carry on going through the turn, see if there's anything that crops up. And we'll just, see what we can do from there on. What's that in Mexico City? World Cup. Took me a while to say that. Is that fuel? Yes, it's fuel. Yeah, it's actually, all's going up. Whoa! Okay, that surprised me. That's 10 million more than it was before. Look at that. It's gone down. It's like, oh, going down. Thanks. Boing. Inflation's, that's risen because, I bought it. Inflation's a really a big pain. Pain, isn't it? Oh, good grief. I was going to do finances. I just want to have a look at, not that. Place salaries, yeah, they'll probably have to go up again when I put the 747 DC-10s in. investment costs, yeah, I want to have a look at that. Africa, I only have two routes going to, so I can put that up a bit. North America, I'm not going to put that up, I'm going to keep it like that. Europe can stay on three, I'm not going to anywhere in Oceania or Asia, but yeah. So that's optimised that a little bit. The investment costs are a tad bit more, it's about 5 million per month. Which make a tiny little dent in my profits. It's not even 100 million more, I don't think. And yeah, to do that, because there's like a 65 million in a, thousand even. Africa, and Well, yeah, how many routes do I have going to it? I think, do I have three, or is it just two? In fact, no, it's just one, isn't it? Because I'm just going to Casablanca. And I keep on thinking that I have a hub in Heathrow. I do not. Yeah, I'm only going to one place in Africa, so... Yeah, that's why that's so cheap. We're now in October. And like I said, we just need, to fast forward a couple more turns. We can go and, be ready for the 747. I don't exactly know when the DC-10 comes out. I know it's... a bit longer after the original 747-100. I think it comes out around the time for the other 747-200, I'm not too sure. Exeter Airport's open. In the UK, where I come from. I see it. I just want to see it for the delight of seeing another UK airport open. In fact, that's higher than some places. In business and tour, I think I might actually start going to some places in the UK, because look at Manchester, look at Liverpool. Look at Glasgow. They do get pretty high. No, not in that way. And I can actually go to Southampton, apart from Heathrow, when I set up a hub there. Anyway, let's go and fast forward one more term out of the 1960s into a new era in my airline. And yeah, which will be starting next episode. We've got 1,000 more passengers, but that doesn't matter. The big matter is the 747s now on the market, and of course there's heavy snow in London and Frankfurt. So yeah, let's just have a... In fact, no, I won't touch the 747 buying thing anyway, absolutely at all. So yeah, that is this episode. Yeah, it's been going on for a while. I don't know how long this is going to be, because yeah, that time lapse... Again, it was pretty long for me. I didn't see how much I recorded before. This bit was a little bit longer. It was quite a bit longer, so yeah. Hope it's a longer episode for you guys, because before I remember I just did a little bit. I only did about 15 minutes of time lapse time, and then I only did a little bit afterwards because I thought that it was I thought that I did longer on the time lapse than I only edited it down to not even 20 minutes. So I like to try and keep this over 20 minutes. So about 25 minutes. I think that's a good content. And for you, enough content. It's half an hour stretching it a bit. For like upload times and stuff, this video is going to be my second last video of it's not going to be my second last video of 2016. What am I about? Part 10 is, and I got to try and upload that. I'm still in the process of editing it. I'm recording this on the 31st of December, you're watching this in the future. Wow. pretty much do that with every single one of my videos. In fact, yes you do, because every time I record a video, I upload it after. So it's always in the future. So, thank you very much for watching. And thank you for taking my happy day. Tune to my channel and click on this video. And hope you watched this whole length. Hope you did. Yeah, I just beckon on me now. My mind sometimes. Good grief. So again, thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you in the next video if you search that one as well. Bye!